it will bring a blessing. No, brother, this is the cross where Jesus died. If you take this little piece of wood, it will bring blessings. Brothers, people have been led into idolatry, but themselves, they don't know. You are there, brother, with a little cross there. If something happened, the cross. Who tells you that that little piece of wood will protect you? Remember, idolatry is when you start representing things which are spiritual, and then you put your faith into them. Brother, the piece of wood does not protect us.
No.
The one who keeps us is God Himself.
Amen.
Our faith is anchored in Him.
Amen.
But what does the devil do? He leads people, oh brother, Mary the mother of God, pray for us. Where have you seen an apostle praying in such a manner? Where have you seen an apostle going to the grave to call upon the dead? Brother, all these things, the same demon that inspired the prophet of Ahab so that they could go and prophesy lies, they are really busy, especially in this age.
Yes, sir.
That's why God has revealed the word in a way that, brother, we can sit down, we can see how the devil deceives people.
Yes, sir.
Even in the message, it comes, brother, there are people today, they've made little relic made out of the wood where Brother Branham heard the voice for the first time. When the Lord spoke to him and told him, don't defile your body, when you will grow older, I will use you. Brother, what will all those do unto you? May the Lord really help
you. Amen.
Idolatry is everywhere.
Yes, sir.
Brother, don't let yourself come first. You can make yourself an idol. God comes before anything.
Amen.
Jesus said, if you don't love me more than yourself, your own life, you are not fit.
Yes, sir.
So even my life must come second. Amen. Why? Because He must come first.
Amen.
May the Lord really help.
Amen.
Brother, the more you move forward, you will understand that demons, they are the ones that cause a lot of troubles in churches. Why? Because through the works of the flesh, they manifest their disorder among believers. Mm-hmm. They inspire others with wrong spirits. Suddenly, you start hating a fellow believer.
Sister.
Why? Because, brother, we will read it. We only saw the first time when Saul hated David. But when you read in the word, even testimonies, brother, you testify, oh brother, the Lord has blessed my brother. Praise be to God. Those words, the more you repeat them, they can start meaning something to someone else. Why? Because it was a testimony, but because you've repeated it many times, they can start meaning something to someone else. Tomorrow, they can start rejecting someone without you knowing that it was just that testimony you were giving, but because you repeated it many times, it then became wrong. That's why, brother, we as believers, we must truly be balanced.
Amen.
When you talk, mind your words.
Yes,
put the words at the right place. Why? Because the devil is roaring. He can give you a wrong conception. But what was strange, Ahab didn't know that he was told a lie. He completely forgot that Elijah had already prophesied against him. He forgot that Elijah told him, the dogs will lick your blood. You Jezebel, the dogs will eat you. He completely forgot. He thought maybe with time, God has forgotten. Brother, the name of Jesus Christ,
amen,
will never change.
Amen.
The baptism in His name will never change.
Amen.
The baptism of the Holy Spirit will never change. The experience of the new birth will never change.
Amen.
But what has the devil done? All those experiences, the devil has perverted everything. If you want to be born again, you just repeat after me. Jesus, I receive you in my life. Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I will follow you. You are born again. You want to speak in tongue? Repeat after me. Ba 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 ba. You've spoken in tongue. You want the baptism of fire, brother? All the genuine experiences, the devil has replaced all of them. That's why, brothers, all of us must know there are things that God is doing. There are also things the devil is doing. What do you want the Lord to do with you? You can become an agent of God. At the same time also, you can become an agent of the devil. Because the two, they are taking place in the church. Mm-hmm. There are those whom God is using. There are also those the devil is using. Don't say, but brother, because we are in the church, nobody's being used by the devil. No. 1 Chronicles 21. The Bible says the devil stood against Israel. Mm-hmm. Can you put verse 1, I think? I'm sure. Must be 1 Chronicles 21. Just that and then we will all pray. 1 Chronicles 21. I'm sure. Right, it's there. What does it say there? And Satan stood up against Israel, provoked David to number Israel. Brother, you read up to verse 7. David was there, a normal man. David was not a pagan. David was a believer. But one day, the devil, he stood against Israel. He then anointed David. Brother David just called one of his servants and told him, go across the country and count men who can go and fight. I just want to know how many they are. His servant, I think Joab, said, no, king. Why will you do such a thing? The man was opposing David, trying to help David. What you want to do is not in the light of the word. You will sin before God. But the Bible says David was adamant. David would not listen. Brothers, my sisters, when God gives you the ability to listen, it's really God's grace.
Amen. Amen.
There are people who don't listen until they have made blunders. Brother, we must learn to listen.
Amen.
May the Lord teach us, when somebody comes and talk to you, brother, sit quiet and listen.
Amen.
You may be wrong. David was there. No, brother, we will come to them. I just want to know. At the end, the men went and counted and counted and counted. He then came back. The men who can fight, this is their number. Those who are able to carry the sword, this is their number. And that was it. Then the Lord sent the prophet and said, David, you've done foolishness. I'm giving you three choices. Mm-hmm. I'm going to strike the first one, the second, and the third. And then the Lord gave David the choice of the three judgment, because I'm going to strike. Of those three, you choose which one you would like me to do. Oh, brother, may the Lord be merciful.
Amen. Amen.
God, because you have sinned, is giving you a choice. I have forgiven you, but you will still pay a price.
Amen.
Forgiveness, yes, belongs to the Lord,
Amen.
But you will pay a price.
Sister.
Demons, brother, be mindful. Don't say, because I'm a born-again Christian, brother, demons can't influence me.
Amen.
Luke chapter 9. What did happen in Samaria? James, John, the Samaritan says, we want to receive you here. None of you will preach here. They looked at the Lord and said, Lord, please, please. Elijah the prophet. They were quoting the word, referring to the scripture. Elijah the prophet, Lord. He called upon the fire, and the fire came down. Please, please. Can we call upon the fire to consume all of these? Brother, what did Jesus say? You don't know the kind of the spirit that is upon you. The Son of Man did not come to lose. He came to save.
Amen.
Brethren, There are preachers. They think maybe God today is not killing enough. God should kill really, so that the fear of the Lord, brother, such a prayer, it shows that you are not under the leadership of God.
Hallelujah.
No, brother, you know God need to restore. No, don't pray so that God kills somebody. It will never work. Brother Branham looked at an older woman. She was there hugging with a young man. Brother Branham was sitting there, already in his heart, Lord, please, this woman, Lord, look what she's doing in public. While he was there thinking of the judgment to fall on the woman, the Lord showed him a vision. And that vision, the anger of God was coming down on him. There was like a bumper that was stopping the anger. And that bumper was actually the blood. And then when the judgment is about to come, it's like there was a protection between the judgment of God and him where he was. And then the Lord told him, you, because of the blood, you've been spared. But that woman, doesn't she also deserve the same protection?
Yes, sir.
Have you spoken to her about the word? He said, no. Go talk to her. He then went and said, I'm sorry, I need to confess something to you. He said, go on. When I was sitting there, I saw what you were doing. I was really saying in my heart, why doesn't God come and just consume this woman? I'm really sorry, but I need to talk to you about the Lord. Brother, he spoke to the woman about the Lord. Before you know it, the woman gave her life to the Lord. And she experienced salvation. There are things, brother, even if something wrong has happened, the way you talk about it, you may think that you are spiritual. But the way you are talking about it, you don't realize that the demons, they are already at work.
Yes, sir.
You are there, you are more your brother. You know, actually, you are in the world, brother. But your claims, they are not claims that are made through the leadership of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, sir.
Because it is easy to do the will of man rather than the will of God. Easy to please man rather than to please God. You are there, brother, even preaching the word. We are praying, brother, Lord, put your word, as Micah cried. I will only repeat what the Lord has said.
Amen.
You are there, why? Because the devil is very cunning. He comes there, brother, you were there reading and meditating. At one time, you become distracted. The devil shows you a completely different direction.
Amen.
You come, you are preaching, oh, brother, you know, I really misunderstood God's word, brother. I think, brother, everything is all right. We are now, you know, time of grace. Brother, please, go, drink juice, sleep, brother. Jesus is coming soon. Brother, I heard these sermons many times. They will make you sick. You are there, you are wondering, what am I, brother? Oh, no, I woke up in the night praying. Forget. Go to bed, sleep. Eat your bread, drink your juice. Jesus is coming soon. You are there, everything looks easy. Brother, was it easy for Paul?
No.
Was it easy for Stephen?
No.
Why will God change? Make it so easy for you in the age of Laodicea? No, brethren. May the Lord bless us.
Amen.
We will continue on Tuesday, the Lord.